In this video, we're going to tear out this ceiling, and we're going to do it right now. So here we are back in the bedroom remodel, and I want to take this ceiling down to get ready to frame and put this thing back together. But before I just go ripping the ceiling down, I want to do a couple things before that.
Let me show you.
So if we go up here into the attic, creepy, not so creepy. So we are up above the bedroom. Bedroom's right there. And as you can see, this is all pine boards, 3/4 inch pine boards. It looks like most of them are 24 inches. Now I want to take those out because I want to frame this and get more insulation in here. And I also have to run wiring. But what I basically want to do is take up all these floorboards, and including some over there. All this is going to get insulation at about that height, if you can tell right there, which ends up being about R49. And then I'm going to make a little catwalk here just to get to this storage area and this storage area over here. So that's the plan. I want to take up all these boards and take out all the insulation that's there. Once I take the insulation out, I'll vacuum up each bay, so that way when I do tear that ceiling off, that's the last thing I'm planning on doing, I at least won't get a bunch of dust and debris and mice poop in my face. That's what we're trying to avoid. And then this will be ready to frame back in and run wire and do my thing. All of these floorboards are coming out. Unfortunately, I'm gonna have to raise this up a little bit, pretty much to the height of that platform, but I'm just gonna do a walkway right here. And this height is not ideal as is, but I need to get the proper insulation in here. It's a good day for work like this. It is raining outside. You'll probably hear the pitter patter. And I've been waiting to do this for a while because in the summertime, it's super hot up here. Luckily, it's not too bad today. So I can put on my long sleeve shirt, which is always a good idea when you're dealing with insulation and all this nastiness. I got my mask, pry bar, hammer, some gloves in there, and you're probably gonna see a lot of stuff floating around. That's a lot of it is fiberglass and just dust in general. So I highly recommend a dust mask. Move the thinking chair. See if I can move this mouse trap without it going off. No mice. So these are actually old cabinet doors that they used at some point to as floorboards. Put this aside for now. The type of insulation that is in this ceiling is very random. This is rock wool, and then there's some old fiberglass. Just want to try and get it out of here without disturbing it too much. And it's always a good idea to get it tested just in case. So actually this is fiberglass, old fiberglass, and then right on top of it in the same bay, rock wool. Guess they wanted to have the best of both worlds. Dirty job. Got to get done. So any of the floorboards that are here that are like this, that are painted or stained, I'm not going to bother saving. But I will save the ones that don't have anything on them because I have been using these for random projects around the house. But like all these, I'm just gonna toss. I'm gonna stack this stuff and see if I can find a use for them in the future. There's a lot of them, but these are junk. This will be nice too because I'll be able to clean up stuff like this. Like this is
one of the lights for the kitchen. I can attach this to one of these or even the strapping and get some staples in here just so it's not all moving around like that. Not a big deal, but it'll be nice to know that all that'll be cleaned up. So that's trash. That's trash. And keep that one. I'm not gonna take all the nails out as I go, but if it's easy, I will. Just like that. I will take these nails out so I don't have issues. It's actually an old piece of door trim. Cool. Is this, see, that's old insulation, but newer than the other stuff. Toss that. See how thick that is? That's gonna be about 10 to 15 times that thickness when we're done. I live in New England. I need the insulation. I need the R value. To it. Of course, it's probably been jostled around a little bit, but it's not gonna cut it. Gotta do better than that. Have you done already? So that's the name of the game. Tear off these boards, save the good ones, take out all the insulation, and then I'll vacuum it as I go. Fun. Let's speed it up a little bit. Here's a good example of why I'm replacing the insulation. All they did was rolled up this paper from the insulation and tucked it in that bag. That is gonna do nothing to insulate. So, take it all up. Oh my god. Oh my god, it's all my spoo. That wasn't fun. Very itchy. The older insulation, definitely there's something about it where it just is way itchier. Like the pieces are thicker, they stick in you easier. It's not fun, and breathing it in and all that stuff. So just be super careful if you're gonna do that. But now we have this whole room, the ceiling exposed. You can see these are 2x6s. They run 10 feet. This way, and actually these are solid 2x6s that go across the entire span of the house, 20 feet, which if there wasn't a wall here, that would be way undersized. And that is sometimes the problem with people thinking they can tear a wall down. If these 2x6s go all the way across, they think, oh, well, there's support all the way across, but that's not the case because these are undersized, way undersized for a span of 20 feet, especially being 24 inches apart, 24 inches on center. I can probably just leave this like this. If I was to just hang drywall underneath or even just leave what's there, it would be fine. Just insulate this up to code. But what I'm gonna do, especially because of this attic staircase, I'm gonna sister up right here, and then this one, and then one, two more with 2x6 that go 10 feet. And then I'm gonna add another 2x6, probably an 8-footer on top of each of these over to here, just so I have a walkway. And then I'll insulate these bays, put my plywood here, and I'll be good. But before I do any of that, what I'm gonna do is tear this drywall out and the ceiling tiles that are down there, expose all this because I wanna make it easier to frame. It'll be easier to get these pieces up here if that drywall is completely removed. And I'm gonna do all my wiring. I have to run some wires throughout the entire house up here to add smoke detectors, but I also wanna run wire for the lights. So I'm gonna tear this drywall out and go from there. All right, you could just grab an end of this drywall and tear it down and make a mess, but I don't like doing that. I like being clean and systematic about this stuff. So I'm gonna take these down one by one. And as I do that, I'm gonna say again, because I've said this in pretty much every one of my videos dealing with these tiles, that I got all this tested, but I keep getting the comments. So I got all this tested for asbestos, and none of this contains asbestos, including these little glue dots right here. It is very common to have those contain asbestos. You say, well, why are you wearing a mask? Well, because nothing's really good for you. No dust or anything that you breathe in, even if this is 100% cellulose, which is basically cardboard, try not to breathe it in. I'm sure at one time these were pretty great tiles, nice style, but they gotta go. Now, I'm gonna try and carefully take this trim off. I might be able to save it. I'm careful enough. This isn't doing anything to hold up this ladder. Yeah, good. I messed up that 45. What are you gonna do? Hey, these are pretty awesome little wireless smoke detectors. They worked great. I'm gonna hardwire some new smoke detectors in, so I won't be needing them soon, but they did work great. If I test this, all of them will go off in the house, hopefully. Sorry, Coda. A moment we've all been waiting for. Now we can see why I did all of the work up there first. Got rid of all that old insulation, all the mouse poop, because I did have a major mouse problem here. I want to eliminate all that stuff falling on my head, because that's not fun. I'm gonna work like a gentleman. And we're gonna listen for what I call the sizzle factor. The sizzle is all that mice poop falling on the floor and going sss. You hear that sizzle? If I didn't clean all that up, I'd probably have a sizzle factor of about 10. Let's see what it's like now. And yes, this is important to me. That's about a sizzle factor of 1. Way better. I like it. Very low sizzle factor. That's what I wanted. Try not to smash this light. Or that camera, like I just did. Take the nails out as I go. That's the boring part. Barely any sizzle. I also got to be careful with this exposed heat pipe down here, the baseboard heat. I don't want to drop this on that. Oh boy. Big piece. Oh sh. I don't want this to fall on the heat. But it's coming, so wish me luck. Did not fall on the heat. It was not up there very good either.
Drywall is down, all cleaned up. Now I have a ladder set up over here because I want to show you this stuff up here. First of all, if you guys know anything about construction, have you ever seen this done this way? This is bizarre to me. I knew that it was like this. It's in the entire original house. This is how the rafter is on the outside here. So what you have is this 2x6 rafter comes down and it's notched right here and it's sitting on a 2x3 and then a 2x3 going this way, and there's like a triangle that creates the soffit. This is the soffit, the bottom of the soffit on the outside of the house, and that is the outside of the soffit. Typically what you do is you do this right here, the notch, bird's mouth that sits right here on the top plate. This is the strapping, this is the top plate. So that sits down, and then you have this piece hanging down past the top plate that creates your soffit that actually hangs down. This I have never seen before, besides this house. And I've seen a lot of old houses, I've torn a lot apart. And I think one of the disadvantages is you see where all of these ceiling joists end, they aren't really tied into much at all. One thing you really want to do with your ceiling joists, if you can, is you tie them into the rafters, the bottom of the rafters, and then you do the same thing on the other side. And that makes a house strong, basically. So this can't blow out this way. But, I mean, it's been standing since 1946. It's just bizarre to me. And I think what I'm gonna do when I put these, when I sister these ceiling joists, is I'm gonna extend them, and I think I'll fill in right here, 2x6, and whatever this gap is, glue it and screw it to this, and then tie this new ceiling joist into that rafter. Do it wherever I can on these, just to make it a little bit stronger. Like I said, been standing since 1946. I'm sure it's not going anywhere, but might as well do it. I think it'll add to the structure. So let me know in the comments if you've ever seen this and what you think. Also, how they tuck this insulation in here, that's doing nothing. So they had insulation, probably, you know, 2-inch thick insulation that went on top of here, and then they tucked it in like crazy right here. But that's the outside of the house. So with my house, this needs to be insulated. This is the heated space. And then above the top plate, it really only needs to go here. I'll go a little bit further out this way, and I'll probably do some soffit vents. But that whole bay, I'm gonna leave uninsulated, because there's no point, because that's the outside. The upstairs, the attic, is not insulated. This is where the insulation ends. See all that black right there? That is probably from lack of air circulation. You see right here, they just, how they tuck that in. Yeah, so I'll just pull those out and leave a space there.
Well, looks like I gotta start putting this bedroom back together. There's gonna be more videos, keep an eye out for those. And if you wanna see some of my other content, you can click here-ish and here-ish and check those out. If you haven't subscribed yet, definitely consider it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.
Almost ready for paint.